are starting with the next family, that is Fabaceae. It is also known as, or rather, it was also known as, because this, the name which we are writing now is the older name. This is a new name which has been given. Earlier it was called Papilionaceae family. And it is actually a subfamily of Leguminosae family. But normally when we talk about Papilionaceae or Fabaceae, we just say it is the family. But it is actually a subfamily of Leguminosae. Again, we will start with the description of the flower. In case of flower, here it is zygomorphic. That means it is bilaterally symmetrical, can be cut into two equal halves only through one plane. The flower is bisexual, hypogynous, complete, and most members of this family have bract. So it is bracteate. Very rarely bract is absent. So we have written all the words. Using this, we'll draw all those structures and write the formula. Now coming from the outermost wall inwards, the first outermost is calyx. There are 5 sepals. Gamosepalous, that means they are fused. Astivation is velvet or imbricate. When we use the word velvet, that means there is no overlapping. Whereas when we are using the word imbricate, that means there is one sepal which is going to be out, one sepal completely in, and 3 are going to be in and out. Corolla, there are 5 petals and the astivation is descending imbricate, or it is written as vaxillary astivation. Now, as soon as we write vaxillary or descending imbricate, we already have the idea how the arrangement is. The posterior petal is large and out. Then there are 2 petals on the sides which have one margin in, one margin out. And there are 2 small boat shaped petals because they are fused, and they are the anterior ones. So as soon as we write vaxillary or descending imbricate, all this information automatically is understood. Now, corolla is this type. Fused or free, because it's a combination. The upper one, that is posterior one, is free, not fused with anything. The 2 lateral are also free. Only the 2 anterior ones are going to be fused. So here we are not writing polypetalous or gamopetalous. In this case, it is already understood that only 2 lower ones or anterior ones are fused. Now coming to androecium. Androecium, there are total 10 stamen. And now comes the identifying feature of this family. These stamens show diadelphous condition. Diadelphous condition means, 1, adelphous word is used when only filaments are fused. Adelphous word means filaments fused. Di means 2. That means out of these 10 stamens, the filaments are fused to form 2 bundles. How are these bundles formed? 9 stamens are fused to form 1 bundle. So we put this 9 in one bracket, and 1 is free. So this is how there are 2 bundles. 1 which is formed by the fusion of filaments of 9 stamens, and 1 stamen is completely free. Gynoecium. Gynoecium is, pistil is with single carp. So it is monocarpillary with marginal placentation. Marginal placentation. Now, whenever such kind of families or such things are to be remembered, it is better to go with a very common example. The most common example of this family is pea. The pea that we eat, we get the pea pod. Now, when we open the pea pod, we find all the seeds arranged on one side, that is only margin. That means placentation is marginal. And when we open it, we see only one compartment. That means it is monocarpillary with only one locule or compartment. So we can say it is unilocular and the placentation is marginal. Ovary is superior. Ovary is superior. Here, the flower was hypogynous, so the ovary has to be superior. Now, using this information, let us write down the floral formula. And floral formula is very, very important in case of this particular family. Flower is bracteate, so we write BR. It is zygomorphic, and there are both the whorls which are there, that is androecium and gynoecium, so it has to be bisexual. Now coming to the whorls, calyx, 5, and they are fused, so we put this 5 in bracket. Corolla, 5, but the upper one is standard, then there are two lateral, and the two anterior ones are fused. So we write it as 1 plus 2 plus 2. The last two, that is anterior two, are fused. Androecium, total 10. But they are arranged in two bundles. We write it as 1 plus 9 are there, which are put in the bracket. After this diagram, which we are going to draw in a minute, we will come back to this and we'll discuss some important things. G is 1. If it is just 1, we don't have to put a bracket, but it is superior ovary. So this is the floral formula. We'll come to this floral formula after we are done with the diagram. Let us come to the diagram. We are drawing the calyx, the outermost whorl. Now it is our choice whether we want to draw velvet aestivation or imbricate. Here we are going to draw velvet aestivation. So, say this is one sepal, the second one, and we are showing velvet aestivation, so there is no overlapping, and we have to show all of them fused. So, we draw this loop-like structure which indicates the gamosepalous condition. Mother axis is going to be here, and let us put this bract. So bract is just an additional structure which we draw. Now coming to the next whorl, that is petals. Now how are these petals? This is the standard, which is the biggest. So this is large petal, which is the standard one. Then there are two which are smaller than this. And if you carefully observe, this margin is in, this is going to be out. And there are two which are very tiny and they are fused. This is vaxillary aestivation. We started discussing this family part with basics, that mother axis is on the posterior side. So posterior petal, that is standard, is the largest, and the anterior two are smallest and they are fused. Now coming to androecium, we have to show the condition where there is diadelphous condition. One stamen is going to be free, so we draw that single stamen free here. Then we'll draw 1, 2 here, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So let us make this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And we have to show these 9 fused. So what we do is we connect them. So we are connecting these 9 stamens to indicate that these 9 are fused to form one bundle and this one is free. Coming to the innermost, that is the pistil. It is unilocular. The placenta is on the margin, and attached to the margin is the ovule. So this is the floral diagram of this Fabaceae family. The characteristic feature are two. One is vaxillary aestivation of the petals and this diadelphous condition of stamen. I told you that we'll come back to this formula after we are done with the diagram. Now let us relate to these two things. Bract we have written here, we have drawn here. Zygomorphic, that means it can be cut only through one plane. So if we cut it like this, then we get two equal halves. But if we cut it like this, we are not going to get two equal halves. So this is bilateral symmetry or zygomorphic. Hermaphrodite, we see both the whorls, reproductive whorls, that is stamen and androecium and gynoecium. Sepals, 5 and fused. Petals. Now, we have written the number as 1 plus 2 plus 2. That means we are talking of this 1, then these 2 and these 2. That means we are going from posterior side towards the anterior side. So this is 1, which is single. 2, these are the 2. They are free, not fused. And these anterior 2 are fused. So we have put these 2 in a bracket. Now, the next word. Androecium. Androecium, we have again taken the one which is free and that is on the posterior. So while writing everything, we are going from posterior side to anterior. So we have written 1 and these 9 as the fused one. But in the book, NCERT book, it is written as 9 plus 1. So either you go from posterior side to anterior side or you go from any one side. But for every structure, the side has to be same. For petals, we are going from posterior to anterior. So here, how can we reverse the direction? So everything has to be in the same direction. But this change has not been incorporated in the book. Till it is incorporated, we will have to select this, though we know that the arrangement has to be from one side only. Either you write posterior to anterior or you write anterior to posterior. But till that change is incorporated, we'll have to stick to what is given in the book. So this is our floral diagram. Now coming to the plants of economic importance belonging to this particular family. So let me just erase this diagram and we'll write down certain important plants. Let us talk about some important plants belonging to this family. That means we are talking of economic importance. Most of the pulses which we are talking of, they come in this particular family. So when we write pulses, which all pulses are going to be included in this? That is gram. Gram is Sizer variety. Then we write Moong, that is Fasciolus variety. Or the genus Fasciolus and all those things in this. Then we have Pisum sativum. Then the next is Gram is here, Moong is here. Then we have Groundnut. Now, groundnut can be used to obtain oil, that is Arachis hypogea. Amongst the pulses, we can include one more, which is commonly known as Tur Dal. It is Kajanus kajan. So, these are the pulses which we consume. Oil. Mainly groundnut. Then we have soya bean. It is Glycine Max. That is soya bean. Then we also get some fibers. The plant is sun hemp. plant from which we get fiber is sun hemp. Oil are done, pulses are done, we also get a dye. And the plant is Indigofera. Certain plants are used as ornamental plants. In ornamental plants, we have lupin and sweet pea. So these are the plants of this particular family which are most important. And the most important which we can remember is the pea plant, which we eat also, the Pisum sativum on which Mendelian work was done. So all these plants are of very high importance and they all belong to Fabaceae or Papilionaceae family. In the next video, we'll take up another family.